I've had people tell me that this can't be healthy long term. I'm sure you hear this all the time. And the artificial sweeteners are what's causing diabetes in the first place. What would your elevator pitch be to answer these critics?
Okay, so let's go back to the sweetener part first, and then let's talk about the long-term aspect of this. We've got two questions here, and I think they're both excellent questions, and I want to make sure that we treat each of them individually. So my feelings about sweeteners are, honestly, we don't know how much sweetener or the very long impact of sweeteners. So I take this in, this is my view on sweeteners. We want to be able to use them as little as possible, and we use them really as a tool to make this intervention sustainable. Because, you know, when it comes to sugar, sugar for anyone with diabetes is going to lead to long-term problems. And so we want to be able to keep people away from utilizing sugar to make foods palatable. But to tell someone who really enjoys sweets that, well, this lifestyle intervention, you can never have anything sweet for the rest of your life, that's not going very far, okay? But I'll say a couple of things, which is, number one, if when people are early on beginning the intervention and they spend even a few weeks early on without eating anything sweet, you know, maybe even staying away from those sweeteners for a short period of time at the beginning, their taste for sweet things will change. And, you know, you have to try it to truly believe that, because I get that comment from people all the time. I can't believe I couldn't eat X, Y, or Z any longer because the sweetness was overwhelming to me. So right there, that's going to enable you to be able to decrease any sweetener use significantly. And then I just say, use sweetener sparingly to make things sustainable, okay? The long-term answers to sweeteners, we don't know, but we have pretty good evidence that processed carbohydrates, including sugar, and their impact on metabolic health for patients with type 2 diabetes, prediabetes, or insulin resistance is negative. So we have to keep both of those things in mind. Now, long-term impact of this, what we know is that long-term impact of our typical dietary guideline associated dietary recommendations has been a failure, has made people sicker. So we have great evidence on this in ketogenic diet in studies out to 56 weeks already. And again, with the improvements in metabolic health, including the huge risk factor for so many diseases, cardiovascular disease, cancer, that is type 2 diabetes, long term, if we are able to reverse people out of that disease pattern, we can say with confidence that they're getting healthier.